We were born to be champions. Oh, we were born to be. We were born to be champions. Oh, we were born to be. We were born to have a name and a light. Cause we're taking a ride to the top, to the top. Born to be.
The winner by 10 for Marco, she's still undefeated, Dylan Marco!
We were born to be champions!
The winner by 10 for Marco, she's still undefeated, Dylan Marco!
We were born to be champions.
The winner by technical knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner by technical knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner, by 10 from Marco, is still undefeated, Dylan. The winner, by 10 from Marco, is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner, by 10 from Marco, is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions. We were born to be champions. Oh! We were born to be champions.
The winner by 10 for knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner by 10 for knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner by 10 for knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner by 10 for knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions. We were born to be champions.
So good evening and welcome to the SM Promotions North vs West Showdown. Our main event this evening, Callum Tombo and Dylan Arbuckle.
We're almost ready to go.
You can hear Craig Stephen there in the back. He is our ring announcer this evening, our host, international sports announcer, and two-time JTV Live Scottish Boxing Ring Announcer of the Year. This is the first thing you watch JTV Live. Click like, click subscribe. Keep the comments.
Ladies and gentlemen.
It's an adult show, but we'll keep an eye on the comments, don't have anything too vulgar.
Would you please welcome?
Do we go around the first bout? The first fight of this evening. This will be Lorna Redfern and Ina Statkovic. They'll be making their way to the ring in just a moment. We'll leave you with the ring cam just now. And I'll be back in a few minutes.
Number one, would you please welcome firstly to the ring all the way from Ukraine, Ina Statkovic. And now, ladies and gentlemen, making her pro debut from Inverness, here comes Lorna to the new Dramossi Hotel here in Inverness, Scotland! Tonight, Steve McGuire's SM Promotions is very proud to bring you an evening of championship boxing. And we start off the evening with the two ladies here in the boxing ring. Our officials appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control's Scottish Area Council. And at ringside, our supervisor is Mr. Paul Graham, alongside our chief inspector, Mr. Robert Craig. Our timekeeper at the bell, Mr. John Bruce, referee in charge, Mr. Kenny Pringle. And this is our opening contest here at the Dramossi for 2 minute rounds in the bantamweight division. Introducing first, boxing out of the red corner. She wears the black shorts with white. She weighed in 117 pounds and 2 ounces. Comes to the ring this evening, contest number 12. From Ukraine, please welcome Ina Statkovic. And across the ring in the blue corner, wearing the camouflage shorts with sparkling red and black trim on the scales, 122 pounds even. This lady, a trailblazer in Highland boxing. She has served with the British Army, where she took Amateur Boxing Association National Championship. Tonight, she makes her professional debut in the ring from Inverness, Scotland. Here is Lorna Redfern!
So, good evening once again. Welcome to GTV Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West Showdown here at the Drumossie Hotel up in Inverness with me, Jamie Alexander O'Neill, our ring announcer this evening. You've just seen him leave the ring, Mr. Craig Stephen, international sports announcer, two-time GTV Live ring announcer of the year. So in the ring making a professional debut, Lorna Redfern. She's boxing Ukraine's Ina Stachkovic. And then after this, we have George Stewart, local boy, boxing Miguel Zamora from Nicaragua. And then Adrian Williamson will be boxing Fernando Duran. And then our main event of this evening, 10 3-minute rounds, Callum Turnbull will be boxing Dylan Arbuckle for the Super Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship. If you are tuning in online, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. Keep up to date with all the GTV Live boxing that's coming up. Shout out to everyone who was boxing at the National Development AB Championships this weekend. Craig Stephen was there announcing and then took the 3-hour drive up to come and announce this event. He'll be travelling back tonight, but I'm staying over. Try to stay good and no go out partying. I know there's a few people up from Glasgow tonight. So final 10 seconds of round number one. This is 4 2-minute rounds. So just to avoid some of the music for copyright purposes, we will be switching to our sponsors in between the rounds. Don't go anywhere.
We were born to be champions. Round 2.
This is round number 2. Lorna Redfern in the blue corner and Ina Stachkovic in the red. So Lorna, well known in this neck of the woods. That's reflected in the support she's got in the crowd. Great work there from Ina Stachkovic, red corner. Lorna really needs to get that corner. She'll be using that ring space well. Zina stalks her around the ring. Ina landing some nice shots there as well. From that left jab, just breaking right down the middle. Lorna try to catch her in the back foot. You know, just sticking with those combinations, just being keeping the pressure up. There we go, move to the body there. Lorna So guys, you're watching JTB Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West Showdown in the ring, round number 3 of 4. Lorna Redfern and Ina Stajkovic. Lorna boxing out the blue corner from Inverness. Ina and the red from Ukraine. I've really been keeping the pressure up these 3 rounds so far. Lorna trying to keep busy there, but you know, just keeping that pressure, has been relentless throughout. Referee takes both boxes apart. Big right there landing from Ina. She has been switching from that body to head. Got a great guard as well. Final few seconds of round number 3. So let's have a look at what we've got coming up for you. This is the programme for tonight. So in the ring, you'll see at the bottom of your screen there, Lorna Redfern from Inverness and Ina Stajkovic from Ukraine. Next up, 4 3-minute rounds. Super featherweight division, George Stewart from Inverness and Nicaraguan Miguel Zamora. And then another super featherweight title, another featherweight title match, Adrian Williamson from Inverness and Fernando Duran from Honduras. And then top of the belt, that's the boxers there, Callum Turnbull from Inverness and Newark Hills, Dylan Arbico. I know both of them well, really looking forward to this, a great 50-50 contest for both. We're going to the fourth and final round. Lorna Redfern in the blue corner and Ina Stajkovic in the red. See, you know, there leads in with that left jab, follows up quite quickly, switches to the body. Big shots are landing, but you know, we'll just switch cameras so you can get a better look. Hey, Final 10 seconds of round number 4. Well done to both boxers. We'll pass to Craig Stephen in the ring with an official announcement. Don't go anywhere, you're watching GTV Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North US Showdown. In the ring now, Warner Redfern and Ina Saskovic. Have a winner for you in just a sec.
So ladies and gentlemen, before we declare the official result, please, your appreciation, both our boxers in the ring. We go to the referee score total, scores of contest 40-36 in favour of the winner from Ukraine, Ina Stepkevich. And ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation, the professional journey starts tonight. The lady from Inverness, Lorna Redfern.
So Lorna's still getting that local support there, our friends and family on their feet. We're at the Drumossie Hotel in Inverness. They're going to play some party games in between. They're going to play a bingo game. Not really much else for us today. If you're watching, give us a shout out. If you want any shout outs for anybody that was boxing today in the National Development Championships, then drop a wee message in the comments. If you're watching on your phone, your TV, grab your phone, you can still join the conversation. Just keep the chat light if you can. Don't be slagging anybody. I don't mind getting a slagging, but don't go too hardcore, please. Don't want to ban anybody for the channel.
So if you get a number,
so still to come,
you don't want that. The minute you get a number,
and we got George Stewart and Miguel Zamora up next. That's 4 3-minute rounds.
That's you out.
And then Adrian and Williamson and Fernando Duran. That again, 4 3-minute rounds, fair away. And then top of the belt
is the winner. Now,
Dylan Arbico from North Hill and Callum Turnbull from Inverness.
And they want to play. If you do, stick your hand up, the girls will get to you. So ladies, please, there are some men, some ladies down here want to play.
So we get some comments coming in. Browns Pest Control. Shout out to Browns Pest Control. They're supporting Dylan Arbico. We've got Craig Pringle. Cheers for the comment. We'll try to get better, but we don't do a lot of pro shows. But the SM Promotions, Stephen Maguire, we do Glen Rothes show, and a lot of the boxers up north, we know a lot of people up here, so they invite us up. We also cover St Andrews show, so we see Dylan a lot. So it's good to see two of these boxers that have sort of followed their career from amateur boxing into the pros, and the two of them are really getting an opportunity to box each other for the Super Bantamweight Championship, Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship. In the wee advert it comes up, it says Bantamweight. That wasn't my mistake. It was a mistake in the original flyer they sent me. But I was corrected.
This table down here, is this got lots? The Jim Smith table. You've got lots of bingo cards on there. You've got loads. Where's Ian Wilson?
I've never seen a bingo game in action.
That's what I'm okay
with. Paul Cushion, how you doing? He's supporting Dylan Arbico. The belt is it? I thought, you know what, I'll go and grab the belt so you can see it, right? But I don't want to cause any drama. Guess like I'm messing about with things I shouldn't be messing about with. So I'm staying up here the night. It was a bit of a check coming up in the train. Craig, I agree with you. I think this will be very interesting. For me, it's a 50-50 contest. Callum, Tombo and Dylan are, because I said I've seen them through their amateur careers, and I've seen every contest they've had in professional. So I think if I had to have dream matches, then there is, I think, as well, George Stewart, he's going to be boxing. So it was Charlie Doig. I'm going to check that out.
I forgot, I'm not in Glasgow. I'm in Inverness. Things like that don't happen in Inverness. Or do they?
Craig's had his iPad stolen, apparently.
Well done, guys. I hope you win.
So, right. While I'm here, while they're playing party games, we're looking for sponsors to support JTV Live. Going forward, we've got a number of sponsorship packages starting at $150. Some of them are up in the screen now. And also, we'll soon be announcing the date for our Scottish Box of Year Awards.
Who's going to come give me a hand? Nicole, are you going to come in?
The Scottish Box of Year Awards will be in September 2024. We'll be starting the nomination process very, very soon. And we're looking for sponsors to support. Support the awards, but also you can take tables, you can be an award sponsor, you can present awards. The details are up on the screen. Our website is down for maintenance this weekend.
She is going to be my gamesman.
Craig Pringle's just corrected, confirmed. Charlie Doig and George Stewart will be boxing in Agua.
Right, that's the prize. £100 goes to the last person standing. Now, it's called Stand Up Bingo, because I'm going to ask you if you're able to stand up.
So, got to have you shout out as well. Good luck to Josh Stewart from Alec, it's his big cousin. And shout out to everybody that follows us and doesn't always get the chance to see. Sometimes we're in the building with them, they don't always get to see the live streams live. But I know there's the St Andrews family. Shout out to the St Andrews family that are watching online as well. The Newark Hill team and the Inverness Boxing Club team, who we're just doing the roads. You've got no excuse not to be here. I know we were busy, the tickets are sold out.
Right, so are we all ready? Eyes down for no numbers.
So we'll be back in just a sec. We're going to pass back. You're going to be sick of these adverts. You'll be sick of these adverts by the end of the night. But I'll be back in just a few minutes.
Right, now, who's all still standing? Have you... Right, those that are still standing, just so we can see you, can you come down to ringside? There's a bit of space on this side. There's a bit of space on
so
this side.
So, we are playing party games in between the contest. So far we've had Lorna Redfern and Ina Stajkovic. Next up, George Stewart and Miguel Zamora.
Nicole, the boxers and the referees.
While we're bringing you this stream for free, there's a few things I'm going to ask you to do. One is to click like. We've only got 7 likes just now. There's about 50 of you watching. We've had 350 views, 7 likes isn't good enough. So unless you want me to switch it on, we'll be start charging. Well, let's see these likes up to 15 in the next few settings. And the other thing I'm going to ask is our JTV Goals youth group, which some of the young people here are supporting the filming tonight. They get us out of trouble, make some money as well for helping us. Our JTV Goals youth group is a youth mentoring project. We're looking at becoming a charity very, very soon, but we support young refugees and asylum seekers in the west of Glasgow. We're looking to kit out our community space, so if you spare £2-3, click the like in the description or go and GoFundMe and search for GTV Goals, it should come up. Shout out to McTaggart Scott, Boxers.
Oh dear. On its own, number 9. That's if there's one of you and you're doing it to yourself.
They were boxing at the National Development Championships. They'll be boxing again tomorrow as well.
That's if there's two of you and only one of you's doing it. 4-8, 48. The man with the moustache is gone. 6-7, 67.
The Craig's loving this bingo caller. Oh. Maybe he does that in his spare time. I don't know. If you're interested in becoming a JTV Live sponsor, as I say, drop me an email, jamie@jtvlive.com, or you can WhatsApp 079-338-60363. We'll watch the end of this.
Don't go anywhere. 3-1,
we'll watch the end of this bingo game.
Next one. 3-9, 39. Oh, the ladies out. 2-3, 23. Don't throw your card away, madam. 6-0, 60. Right, sir. You need to give me the card. Okay, now I'm going to shout them out. You tell me if they're on there. Number 4. Number 8. Number 10. Number 15. 22. 27. 30. 33. 47, 52, 58, 63, 75, 82, and 86 was the number. There you are, sir. You are the winner, and I have for you 100 pounds. Well done. Thank you, Nicole, and thank you to everybody who played the game. Right, we normally do red and black. Most of you, loads of faces I see in here. What game do you prefer, the bingo or the red and black? Red and black, this man says. You only like red and black because you can cheat in that. I've seen you cheating. I've seen you. You've got a cheat haircut. This is a haircut. This is the, I've got no hair. This is the haircut of an honest man. Mr. Bruce will tell you that. This man here will tell you that. That's the haircut of an honest man. I would love to be, I would love to have your hair, sir. I would love it. I'd love it. But if it made me a cheat, I'd go for that. Right, so what are we going to play next time? Are we going to play bingo?
He just loves playing these games. Matty Clark, how you doing, my man?
Next time?
Thanks for tuning in.
Next time we're up here.
JNP, shout out to Icons Box Club. You all did so well today. And good luck to Marcus, who's in the semis tomorrow from Super Grand Poland. Is that your first name? I didn't know that. Been supporting the live stream since day one. So he said about 5 minutes' time, we're going to go to the second contest of this evening, George Stewart. And he is boxing Miguel Zamora from Nicaragua. Then Adrian Williamson and Fernando Duran. Then Callum Turnbull and Dylan Arbico. We're going to switch to the adverts for a bit. I know you hate me. We won't be too long. Here we go.
undefeated from Inverness, Callum.
The winner by 10 from knockout is still undefeated, Dylan.
So welcome back to GT Vibes coverage of the SN Promotions North Belf West TV Showdown.
Anybody at home you have that you want to see this?
Nathan Lundy, Dylan will be on the fourth, fight this evening. We're just about got to the settings.
Here we go.
Big good luck to Joel Stewart from Alec again. Craig Pringle, Scottish fight. I'd like to see as a title fight. Dylan Arbuckle and Callum Turnbull. Here we go. So if you're just joining us, welcome to GT Vibes coverage at SN Promotions North versus West Showdown. So make a tongue twister. Craig Stevens in the ring. We'll pass back to him as he introduces the second contest of this evening.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to all those in attendance here at ringside. A very warm welcome to our viewers joining us on JATV. This is our second contest. This is 4 3-minute rounds of international super featherweight action. Our timekeeper at the bell, Mr. John Bruce, the referee in charge, Mr. Kenny Pringle. Introducing first, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the dark blue shorts with white trim, weighing in 141 pounds even. His record includes 15 wins. 14 of the 15 come by way of knockout from San Pedro Sula, Honduras, Fernando Turan.
And across the ring in the blue corner, winning the magnificent black with green and gold. He weighed in 136 pounds even. He brings a perfect record for contest, 4 wins, 1 win by KO, from the town of Alness, Ross and Cromarty, Scotland. He is the undefeated Aidan Williamson.
So we're going to round number one. Shout out to our Antony Boxing Club friends who are watching online. Carson Green, we box in the National Development Championships as well, so good luck to Carson. There is a young guy from a youth group joining their team on Monday. This is round number one, Aidan Williamson in the blue corner and Fernando Duran in the red. Did you hear that? He's 15 wins, 14 by knockout. For 3 minute rounds. Aidan always puts on a show for the home crowd here. Oh, someone in the crowd just fell. Oh, she's all right. Aidan, a very capable boxer. I said this last time we were up here. Callum, Aidan, George and Ulan. There's a nice wee team of boxers that train out of Inverness. Aidan and George. Both super featherweights, so get a lot of sparring in. And Callum, not too far off them, super bantamweight. Shout out to Zach Hutchison, who's watching. I'll be in Glenroth, it's the 10th of November. Is that right? Oh, it's 10th of November, aren't it? I need to check my notes. I've not seen enough of the advert that pops up. I'm sure Daddy Scully will drop me a message, let me know where I'm supposed to be. That's straight left there, coming from Aidan. Nice consistent work there from Aidan. So I said, a very capable boxer again, boxer we've watched. Big shots there landing from Fernando Duran, the red corner. Throughout the last few seconds around number one, and Aidan steps it up. This crowd get behind him. A lot of them have their phones out. I shouldn't have bothered coming up. They've all got their phones out filming. Why am I here? They better get off the Wi-Fi, see the Wi-Fi start tripping. So guys, you're watching JTV Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West Showdown. Topping the bill this evening, Callum Turnbull and Dylan Arbico, Inverness vs Newark Hill. I'm sat behind the two Western Isles tables. Get Jim Smith and John McKenna right in front of me. Shout out to both of them. So Danny says, so our favourites, Antony, 19th of November, 10th of November, Glenrothes. Well, here we got the round number two.
Second time.
This is Aidan Williamson in the blue corner and Fernando Duran in the red. We're at the Drumossie Hotel here in Inverness. I think the temperature's set to drop here tonight. It was a bit chilly outside. They've been in perfect control throughout this contest so far. Devin will be on top of the bill. There's another fight after this. There's four fights in total. Both four rounders. If it's easier for you to drop us a WhatsApp message, WhatsApp 07933860363. I'm reading the messages as they come in. Don't send any bad stuff, please. Big shot there, landing nice right uppercut followed by the left. Ziskow gets on their feet. Fernando Duran, tough boxer as we find on Duran's boxers. Quite nice consistent work from Aidan. If it continues to go this way, I'll be grabbing him for a chat. One of the things I'll be asking is if he thinks he's ready to start moving up to the six in 10 rounds, like Callum has. Footwork there from Aidan as well. He's syncing it perfectly with that, those combinations, just getting in and out where he needs to be. Final 10 seconds of round number two. Once again, this is 4 3-minute rounds. Hey guys, you're watching JTV Live's coverage at SM Promotions North West Showdown. Callum Turnbull and Dylan Arbuckle will be main event. We'll be back just after this. Hey guys, welcome back. You're watching JTV Live's coverage of SM Promotions North vs West Showdown. We've got it to round number three. Aidan Williamson in the blue corner from Inverness, boxing Fernando Duran in the red corner from Honduras. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. Shout out to Ginge, who's watching from Glenrothes Boxing Club. We'll see you in a few weeks at a new venue. In fact, Ginge, I need to ask you, is that new venue capable of live streaming? Because we've never been able to live stream the Glenrothes events because it's so packed. There's no space to do anything, never mind put a table in. In the ring, Fernando Duran. As I said, tough boxer. Aidan has been more consistent throughout the three rounds so far. Shout out to Nathan Lundy, who's watching online. So this is four 3-minute rounds, and next is 4 3-minute rounds, and then the main event is 10 3-minute rounds. So it won't be too long. Nice head movement there. Feet movement as well. Aiden just oozes this comfortability in the ring. Great work there, big shots landing. And I've said that Honduras boxers are tough boxers for that big right. He has won 14 of his 15 contests by way of knockout. Oh, big shot landing. I mean, it's there. He needs to. Aiden has been comfortable and more consistent throughout, but he does need to watch those big shots. Somebody just shouted DDT. This isn't the WWE. Benno, 10 seconds of round number 3. We'll be back in just a moment. Guys, welcome back. Just gonna the fourth and final round.
Second round, fourth and final round.
There's Aidan Williamson, Fernando Duran. So the crowd lively as always at the Dramosi Hotel, the new Dramosi Hotel. The referee Kenny Pringle, the third man in the ring. Big shots that landed from Aiden. Is it very comfortable, consistent throughout. Let me know if any issues with the stream. We did start with a low quality stream, going out, we've bumped up a wee bit. If you ever get any issues like that, just let us know in the comments, we'll sort it.
Hey,
Ian Ross will switch that in just a second. Penalty says around number four. Be back in just a minute with the why not? So you're watching JTV Live's coverage at SN Promotions North vs West Showdown with me, Jim Alexander O'Neill. Just before we go into the ring, the official announcement of the second contest of this evening. Shout out to Franco and Lauren. Lauren is Dylan's cousin. Whoever messaged me, you said hi Craig. My name's Jamie. Craig's the ring announcer. And a lot better look at me. So we're just about to find the winner of the second contest. We have reduced the quality slightly. Let me know how the signal is. I'll keep an eye on that. We've got a backup Wi-Fi signal we can switch to.
Boxers, please, your appreciation for both our boxers in the ring. Now, I know how excited you guys get at ringside, and I absolutely love it, but please do me a favour, no breaching of these ropes. One person in here, including you, Scott, you've got a pair of gloves on. One person in here, and I'm getting sent home, so don't get me sent home. Ladies and gentlemen, we go to a referee score totals, 40-36, the winner. He is still undefeated from all West, Simon Williamson! Ladies and gentlemen, please your appreciation, the man from Honduras, Fernando Duran. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have another little break before the next contest comes in. What we're going to do this time is we are going to do the draw, the £10 in the envelope for the Mike Tyson glove. Now, the girls are going to come round. Aisha, Nicole and Kaylee are going to come round collecting the envelopes. If anybody has, they want an envelope, they don't have a tenner, they don't have a change of 20, speak to Nicole. She's got change. If you need change for a 20, speak to Nicole, because she's got change. Remember, please, write your name on the outside very, very clearly. I'll play some music. We'll come back in the ring in 5 minutes' time. And we will see who wins the Mike Tyson glove.
And guys, while we're waiting for the next contest, Aidan Williamson. Ryan Cameron. What camera am I on? There we are. How are you feeling?
Aye, good, yeah. It was good to just get back in the ring after that time and fucking do what I love.
I was saying, like, you're comfortable throughout the four rounds. Callum's moved up. He's got a 10-rounder tonight. What's next for you? We've got to start seeing the 6-8.
I'm happy doing anything, absolutely anything. I'd like to go for a title, but it's all down to Stevie, but I'll take anything, absolutely anything.
Somebody asked me in the comments, who would you want to see box? I think after that for a Scottish title. I think after that performance, I mean, I've been up seeing you guys before. We spoke about Sasha. I know you've had a bit of time. There's a few cancellations and that. But you need to start coming down to Glasgow, maybe even a bit further down south. Is that the plan?
Aye, I'll go absolutely anywhere.
You're going to bring us all with you?
Oh yeah, definitely, definitely.
So I know you've got a few fans, man. I did pull you away for some of you. You went straight out, but I was like, nah, you get you back. What's it like? I mean, this atmosphere is always brilliant. A few of them were getting up to the ropes. Craig had to give him a warning. But what's it like having that support?
Oh, it's good, Elliot. There's nothing better than getting like your own home crowd shouting for you. It's just something that can't be beaten, you know what I mean? A feeling that can't really be explained apart from it's amazing, eh? It's good.
Now, you and George are the same. You're sort of the same weight, innit?
Nah, yeah, me and Joe.
Is that a lot of sparring in the gym?
Yeah, aye, definitely. Definitely, aye.
How's that been with helping your progress in that?
Aye, good, yeah, good sparring for everyone in the club, to be honest. Callum's a good sparring too, he's fast as fuck, a boy my weight, so it's good, there. It's really good.
Right, man, and you don't know where we're going to see you next, but...
hopefully very soon.
Any exclusive for goal, maybe in a few more, say like you don't know yet?
I don't know yet myself, I'm just waiting for a phone call.
Anybody wants to box home, give me a shout. I'll only take 10-20% of the finder's fee. Who are we going to shout out to?
Anyone.
Who's that waiting for you? Who's that waiting for you?
That's my wee sister. Shout out to my wee sister.
You want to shout it out? Come. What's her name?
Maisie.
Squeeze right in. How are you doing? You enjoy that?
Yeah, I loved it.
Were you filming?
No, I'm on front.
Boxes at the club.
Yeah.
Oh, so who's that?
Robbie Johnson.
Yeah, Robbie Johnson.
So Robbie's on FaceTime with us. Are you watching, Rob? I can't hear him, but I hope you're watching the JTV Live YouTube channel. That's Robbie there. I don't know if you can see him. listen. Hey, did I let you go? Did they always spell your name wrong?
No, that's A-D-I-N.
Aye. So, Craig's music's cut off, so I'll let you go as we prepare for the next fight. Join you on the night, Maisie. Thanks for talking to me. Cheers. So, guys, you're watching JTV Live's coverage of SM Promotions, North vs West. showdown. We're at the new Jamossi Hotel here in Inverness. We'll be back in a few minutes. So hello, welcome back to SM Promotions North vs West Showdown. We're going to George Stewart and Miguel Zamora.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to go with the third contest of the evening. Please welcome from Managua, Nicaragua, Miguel Zamora.
Gentlemen, here we go. This is contest number three of a fantastic evening of boxing brought to you by Steve McGuire's SM Promotions. It's the North versus West Showdown. This is our chief supporting contest, and once again, a very warm welcome to our viewers joining us here in Inverness live on JATV. So this is our chief supporting contest for 3 minute rounds, an international featherweight contest. Timekeeper at the bell, Mr. John Bruce. Referee in charge, Mr. Kenny Pringle. Introducing first the boxing out of the red corner, wearing the blue shorts with white trim. He tipped the scales, 141 pounds even. Four contests, two wins, only one defeat, one draw. From Managua, Nicaragua, Miguel Zamora! And across the ring in the blue corner, he wears the white, black, silver and tartan shorts. He weighed in 133 pounds even. He is undefeated 4-0. From the capital of the Scottish Highlands, the beautiful city of Inverness, Scotland, the Highland Warrior, George Stewart!
So this is 4 3-minute rounds. George Stewart and Miguel Zamora. George box out the blue corner. A shout out to everyone from Everest Boxing Club in Glenrothes, who always supports us up north. And all our friends and supporters around Scotland. We gave some shout outs earlier. Antonine Boxing Club, McTaggart Scott, Newark Hill, the St Andrews Sporting Club team. I've got a few Glaswegians in front of me. St Andrews and Newark Hill lot. The banter is on point. Josh Shutt, another boxer that I've followed his boxing career. I've seen him box up here a few times. This is his fifth professional matchup. Big shot there landing. Felt that from here. Again, he's boxing tough Nicaraguan. Keep the likes coming in. It does support our channel. Click subscribe as well. You keep up to date with all future live streams. Let's get one more contest after this. The Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship. Callum Turnbull versus Dylan Arpicot. George has a lot of support here. There's a few members of his family as well, boxers. Great uppercut there, landing, but Sid Miguel is tough. Well, not to use that ring space. Well, but George keeping that pressure up. I don't know if it was Ian Wilson or no, but somebody just shouted to his table, "Watch your head, ref." Ian Wilson, our two-time Scottish Boxing Promoter of the Year, GTV Live Scottish Boxing Promoter of the Year. And they celebrated their 50th anniversary year. So how are we doing this Saturday night? I know a lot of people that follow the channel would be involved somewhere or another at the National Development Championship. Just want to say a shout out to everybody who's boxing. This could be where your boxing career starts at the Boxing Scotland National Development Championships. It continues tomorrow. You can see the live streams at Boxing Scotland's official YouTube channel. You can watch back all the competitions so far. Started last night, carried on today and then tomorrow, and then it concludes next weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday as well. Some finals already taking place, but shout out to everybody that's starting their boxing career. I know it's up to six bouts. Some people may have been boxing already for a while.
Seconds out.
You go round two. Number two is 4 3-minute rounds. George Stewart in the blue corner and Miguel Zamora from Nicaragua in the red. So I'll bring you this live stream for free. We'll also be posting the four contests in the next day or so for you to watch back in full HD. if you think it's worth £2-3, then you can click the link in the description for JTTV Goals Youth Mentoring Project. The guy in the camera is Fair, well, Youth Mentoring Project. He's travelled up with his Inverness. Nice work there from Miguel in the red corner. George now turning that pressure up again. You see him there just taking a wee half step back, making it difficult for Miguel to land. So you should be able to rewind and watch back the contests that have been on so far. This is round two of the third contest. George Stewart versus Miguel Zamora. But earlier we had Aidan Williamson and Fernando Duran. And kicking us off is Lorna Redfern and Ina Stajkovic. Is George looking for that big finish? Just holding back as we got to the closing seconds of this round. So are you liking that? Don't forget, click like and subscribe. You've got a minute before the third round starts. I'm going to pass to our sponsors. Thank you to everybody that's been sponsoring JTV Live so far. Here they are. So we go third round of four. I never say third and final round, I'm too used to the amateurs. And a boxer will forward from the amateurs into his fifth professional contest this evening. George Stewart in the ring against the Nicaraguan Miguel Zamora. Miguel using that ring space well, but I don't think he's thrown enough. He's thrown a big one there. But George keeping that pressure up. We're about halfway through round number three of four, and then possibly have a short break, maybe 5 minutes or so, and then we'll have our main event. 10 3-minute rounds for Callum Turnbull versus Dylan Arbico. You've been waiting patiently online, keeping the comments nice and polite. Moving a body shot there. Kenny Pringle separates both boxers. And we go back to that jab. Big body shot there landing, but George just continues, goes for the uppercut there. Final 10 seconds of round number 3. This is the fourth and final round. George Stewart, Miguel Zamora. You're watching JTV Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West Showdown here at the New Dromosi Hotel in Inverness. Next up, we have a Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship match for you. Callum Turnbull, Callum Turnbull versus Dylan Arbuckle. In the ring now, George Stewart and Miguel Zamora. Nice work, girlfriend. From George, Miguel walks in nicely on the back foot at times, just landing a wee shot or two and then using that ring space. Crowd getting behind our local boy, George Stewart. Nice work there from Miguel, but George determined to keep that pressure up. Final 10 seconds of round number 4. Wow, great work there from both boxers. We'll be back with the official announcement with Craig Stephen in just a second. Here is our list of our sponsors before we get that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pringle will bring both boxers to the centre of the ring, and as he does so, please, get appreciation for both our boxers. We've got our referee score totals. Scores this contest 40-36. The winner is still undefeated from Inverness. Ladies and gentlemen, just before George leaves the ring, he's got a very special dedication for this one. Where's David Alexander? Where are you? David. We've got a wee family birthday. I'm going to ask our supervisor, can we... Right, you just get him. Come on, David. You're not allowed in the ring, but you're allowed on the apron. Okay. David Alexander, 23 years old today. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear David.
Happy birthday
to you. Right, so ladies and gentlemen, just before the main event comes in, we told you there's something in between each one. We've got two last things to do. First one, we're going to auction this. It's not a poster, this is a banner. This is a full plastic banner on the wall. This is unique, as in there ain't going to be another one of them in the world. All the boxers will sign this for the winning bidder. Right. Who will start it off?
And while they're doing the bidding, how you feeling, my man?
Oh, absolute buzzing, mate. I haven't fought since February, so buzzing, eh?
I know, and I said this earlier to Aidan, I was like, I know you guys keep busy in the gym, like trying to spar. You between you, Aidan, and Cam, so that much difference in the weight. So you get a good shot at each other. All yous are fighting for it. Quite a tough opponent, though, at times, though.
Oh, mate, he was, yeah, especially for his record. Two wins, one loss, one draw. He's a tough boy, like. Really tough boy.
I just think, for me, just kept that consistency up in the four rounds. I know we said this last time, when are we going to start seeing you itching into the six and the eight and the 10 rounds?
In 3 weeks' time, I do a 10-rounder.
Oh, I know that as well. So you're going, 3 weeks' time, you're going to be boxing Charlie, Doig and Arwa. Are you looking forward to it?
Oh, mate, I can't wait. So buzzing, eh?
This was supposed to be at the Lemons Burns night, was it not? And then, was it... Who was the real one? He's one of
it was myself. I had a sinus infection, so I had to go on medication, but they wouldn't let me pass the medical, so I got pulled out over that, so I've got it, like.
Recovered, as we've just seen. As I said, fighting fit, ready to go. It's getting weird for me now, because I know you, I know Charlie, I know Darren, I know Carl. It's like I'd rather just be in the audience and maybe watch with my fingers, but it's good, man, because I've been up here before. I know how much work you've put in. And I want to see you start getting these bigger fights. I know Charlie as well is putting a lot of work. So it's good. It's coming down to the mere 50-50 fight. So that was that far off it anyway, no?
That definitely wasn't far off it. That's what I want, you know. I want that 50-50 fight. I want to step up more. So.
And as always, the crowd, this place was like, you could feel the rumble when you came out there. What's it like having this lot behind you again?
Oh, it's amazing. I can't thank everyone enough, you know. Being in your hometown, fighting in front of everyone, everyone supports you. It's a good crowd.
And they're going to have to start travelling down south.
Yeah, I can't wait to. I want to travel all over, so.
That's a bad time when you for boxing fans or people who've got mates. Like, the better they become, the more money you're going to have to spend in travelling. But it's important, man. So people get your money, get the tickets sold. It's a good night anyway. It's a good night out, whether you're boxing up here or boxing down there or Glasgow, whatever. Who are we giving a shout out to?
Oh, I was giving a shout out to my brother. That's why he's 23 today, so I thought I'd give him a little surprise and get him shouted out. I think he was over the moon with that. So, especially my family, you know, they're always behind me. My dad he was in the corner. Stevie forgetting me the fights, you know. Everyone's done everything for me, so I just got to put in the work. So
he did a hard part.
I did a hard part.
Listen, George, I'll let you go. Celebrate. We've got one more contest coming up. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back very, very soon.
Are we done at 300?
We were born to be champions.
The winner, by 10 from Marco, he is still undefeated, Dylan.
Come on.
We were born to be champions.
The winner, by 10 from knockout, he is still undefeated, Dylan. Still undefeated, Dylan.
We were born to be champions.
The winner, by 10 from knockout, is still undefeated, Dylan.
Guys, we are seconds away Scottish from the main event of the evening, Scottish Triple Bantamweight Championship.
The first of our challengers is just about to make his way to the ring. So would you please welcome, all the way from Newark Hill, in Lanarkshire, here comes Dylan
watching JT Vance coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West showdown in the ring. Devon Abico and Callum Tombo, as they are just about to enter 10 3-minute rounds for the Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship. Let's pass to Craig Stephen in the ring as he introduces both boxers.
You are all very welcome here to the centre of the boxing universe. We're in the Dromosi Hotel in Inverness, Scotland. This is North versus West Showdown, brought to you by SM Promotions, and this is our featured contest of the evening.
$1!
show, I think. Just a wee bit of technical difficulty there. We'll be back in the ring just a second. Dylan Arbuckle and Callum Turnbull, Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. Just pass back to Keith Stephen in the ring.
10 rounds of boxing for the vacant Scottish Super Bantamweight 122-pound crown. All our officials ringside have been appointed by the Scottish Area Council of the British Boxing Board of Control. Our supervisor is Mr. Paul Graham. He sits alongside our Chief Inspector, Mr. Robert Craig. Our medical officers are Doctors Louise McCulloch and Mark Malavage. And our inspectors working the corners are Tony Robertson and Mr. Bobby Russell. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. John Bruce. And in charge of the action, our referee from Hamilton, one of Scotland's finest, Mr. Kenny Pringle. And so, ladies and gentlemen, for the sold out hundreds in attendance here at ringside, for all those watching live on JATV, the officials are ready, the boxers are ready. Are you ready for the meeting? Introducing the first of our challengers. He boxes out of the red corner. He wears the white and pink shorts. Weighed in 120 pounds and 4 ounces. An undefeated record. 3 contests, 3 wins. With 2 big wins inside the distance from Muir Hill, Lanarkshire, Dylan Arbuckle. And across the ring in the blue corner, wearing the white shorts with yellow and black trim. He tipped the scales 119 pounds and 4 ounces. He too is undefeated. 4 contests, 4 wins with 1 KO. From the Highland capital, Inverness, Scotland, Callum Titanium
So guys, you're watching JTV Live's coverage of the SN Promotions North vs West Showdown in the ring, our main event. Dylan Arbuckle in the red corner from Ute Hill. And Callum Turnbull from Inverness. Here we go. Round number one, scheduled for 10 3-minute rounds. You remember both these boxers. I think the first time they've both done 10 rounds. Well, both scheduled to do 10 rounds, so they want to pace herself so much. Maybe just suss each other out a bit. But if they do see an opening, we did see this as a 50-50 fight. Biggest test of either of the professional boxing careers so far. We are at the sold out new Dromos Hotel in Inverness. Dylan has brought a big following with him as well. And both boxers have a lot of support online. And back and forward there. This crowd gets behind both the boxers. I know both these boxers well. It's a bit weird feeling, a bit nerve wracking. Nice back and forward there again. They are going to test each other. We did say 50-50 fight.
Come on, come on.
Final 10 seconds of round number one, and what a opening first round it's been. Wow, great opening first round. If we have 10 of these, this will be shaping up to be a bit of a belter. So Dylan Abico in the red corner and Callum Turnbull in the blue. Both testing each other, I've said it non-stop, 50-50 bout this is. Both looking to make that step up and to get a Scottish Super Bantamweight title this earlier in their professional careers. Just shows you the work rate that they put in. Not just as professionals, but as amateurs guiding them towards this. Didn't seem that long ago, Dylan won the Scottish Elite Championship, which is now the Golden Gloves, Boxing Scotland. So, keep the comments coming in online. Don't go quiet on me. We've got round number two.
Round two.
Both boxers capable of throwing these snap jabs. They just come out of nowhere. And then that loaded right. And the other thing is they don't back down. If they do get hit with a jab, they're just straight in there again just to try and pick up points for themselves. Nice work there, Dylan Abico. Get the pink and white bad boy shorts. But as we've seen for the other Inverness boxers earlier, they're very fit as well, fighting fit. Nice work there for Dylan as he starts to find his rhythm. We've seen Dylan's last matchup. He got a spectacular second round knockout. The young guy was in the ring, we didn't really know where he was afterwards. Dylan keeping that pressure up as Callum tries to look for an opening to respond. Dylan definitely been a busier boxer, switching to the body there. As I said, both boxers are capable of throwing these very sharp jabs and then falling up right. Straight away with the right hand. They see an opening. See Dylan there throwing that left sometimes down to the body and then try to throw the right to the head straight after. Keeping that right loaded, but keeping it as a guard as well, because Callum has caught him earlier on. Got it the final few seconds of round number two. Wow, another great round there. Some of the crowd on their feet. I don't know how much you can see there. Them supporters are right in front of me. But I think still earlier in the matchup, Dylan started to find his rhythm a bit more. Seeing Callum get caught here and there, he's trying to see openings. Dylan, for me, busier in that round. First round, probably a bit even, try to suss each other out. If you get any thoughts, a lot of you are better than me commentating. Let me know what your thoughts are. We've got that camera that gets right up there. I know the ropes are a bit awkward, but you should be able to see a better view of what I can see. So guys, you're watching JTB Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West showdown. We waited the whole night for this. Devon Abico and Callum Tumbo. This is round number three. Callum, try to keep that composure there. But Dylan keeping the pressure up. Big right there landing from Dylan after a few quick jabs. They get a bit scrappy. Kenny Pringle keeping an eye on the action up close. Again, Dylan from that left and right. Callum just losing his... a bit disorientated, just needs to keep that stance, keep his composure as we've seen earlier in this round. Try to loosen up a bit using that ring space. Dylan just keeping focus, keeping his eyes trained on the target. And he is like this outside the ring as well. He's cool, calm and collected. Callum, to be honest as well, he's a tough young boxer. Spoke to him earlier. They both had their moments. Callum now getting a bit more confident. He's starting to find his rhythm in this round. Dylan just switching back to the basics. He's trying to let Callum dictate where he's to go in the ring. Great work from both boxers. So far. You see a change in Callum for Ellen, even in this round. He's starting to get a bit more composed. Dylan trying to keep that work rate up. Callum tries to torment him, try to wind him up. And this is what I mean with these two, they can switch it up that quickly. They didn't need to pace ourselves for the 10 rounds. See Dylan smiling there as he goes back to his corner. Another great round there, I think. For me, Callum started to find his feet and his rhythm. And that's why this is, I'm going to say again, 50-50 very sunny, brilliant. He walks in smiling, he's happy. But great work there. As I say, two fantastic boxers that we've followed. They've been in JTV Live since we started way back in 2019. I'm getting like goosebumps. This is weird. No felt like this in a long time. Watching a pro fight. But as I said, I know both the boxers well. And I was starting to feel a bit nervous coming up to it, because I know what they're both capable of. That's the thing. We will go on to the third.
Round four,
I nearly said round three. And the crowd is loving this, I can just tell you that. Shout out to Liam Coyle, who's supporting Dylan online. Get a bit scrappy at times, but we've both seen what they're capable of. Callum was just showing off a wee bit, trying to wind Dylan up towards the end of that third round. I think Dylan was smiling as he went back to his corner. I think he enjoyed it. And that's the thing, both of these boxers just love to box. If they need to go in for a scrap, they'll take it there. But this title and this fight means a whole load to both of them. They're looking to make a step up very early in their careers. Devin just trying to still force Callum in the back foot, get him against the ropes. Callum can switch it up and he'll come out fighting if he needs to. Switching to the body now from Devin. Callum does the same. Sometimes almost like a mirror image each other. It's like a very intense spar. Big shots there landing from Callum. Devin switches back to that straight jab. Just sticking to the basics. Callum switching body, head, body. A shout to young James Cushing, who's watching and supporting Devin online. What a main event this is lining up to be. I think earlier on both boxers are looking for an opportunity to see if they can get maybe a quick finish, test each other out. No, it's a case of trying to wear each other down. Got it the final few seconds around number four. Wow. We're scheduled for 10 rounds. It may go that long. But what? The first four rounds have been brilliant. I could probably watch this all day. And you can watch it back. You can watch it back on JT Vibes YouTube channel. You're about to get the round number five. Shout to all our sponsors, you'll see them scrolling along the middle of the screen. Amaramo & Co, shout out to the firm, watch the firm, and BBC iPlayer, it's back on BBC Scotland tomorrow at 9. The firm is a fly the wall documentary of Amaramo & Co and his team, and the Casey they'll be working on. Amar's been a friend of mine for years, but also a supporter of JTV Live and our Scottish Box of Year Awards. So we've got the round number five.
Second round, round
five. I think the game plan would be, as I just said, around four, start wearing each other down. See them both taking opportunities to switch to the body. Just forces the hands down in the later rounds. Still aiming for big shots, nice big straight right to the chest there from Devin. An absolute battle this has turned out to be. They both want this title. These combinations are coming from Carlo. He's got on the white and gold. both still looking for openings and then just punishing each other in the retaliation. Right there, coming from Rodella and Callum, they're the one try to force him in the back foot. Final 10 seconds of round number 5. They'll get his guard up, taking it to the centre of the ring. Both boxers definitely starting to find the rhythm, as I said, walking each other down when they can. We'll be back in about half a minute or so. So thank you to all our sponsors who've been supporting JTV Live and our Scottish Boxing Year Awards. Get in touch if you're interested in supporting us. We've got to round number 6, 6 of 10 on the schedule. Dylan Abaco in the white and pink Bad Boy shorts. And Callum Turnbull in the gold and white. This is for the Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship belt. Josh Alexander, I agree with you. First round I had it slightly even, but I just had Dylan up. So I've got Dylan up by one round getting into this. But Callum's starting to find his rhythm, as I said. See, at the end of round number 3, he's starting to be a bit more comfortable. Try to wind Dylan up. We see it here, he's spinning like the Tasmanian devil. And he does have that comfortability in the ring. But as is Dylan has been a lot of tough bouts, not just as a professional, but as an amateur. As I said, it doesn't seem that long ago when he won the Scottish Elite Championship. This is shaping up to be an absolute belter of a contest. Apologies for the people in front of us. Come on, spot girl from Carl. Obviously we got to the closing moment. Ellen looking to land a big right. And the bell will sound. So that's been six rounds down so far. We've got another four scheduled. Gavin, is it Buchan? I agree, I think. Callum is starting to get stronger as the round's going. As I said, both tough boxers, both would be training for this. Means a lot to both of them. We've got four more rounds left on the schedule, and I'm hoping it goes. I hope it goes to the 10th round. I'd like to see maybe in the last round a knockout, maybe. As I said, I like both these guys. They're putting their heart and soul in it. They've really put on a show so far. Round number 7. Here we go. Dylan still using that ring space when he can. He has his guard up, he's just looking for that perfect time to throw that left or right. But Carl loosened up at the end of the third round. Really started to show his talent and skill. It was never going to be easy for either one. Dylan trying to keep busy, just here we step back, making it difficult for Callum to land. Callum pushing forward. And that's the thing, not either of them has backed down since that first bell went in round number one. For both boxers, this is what they want, but be careful what you wish for. This is when it starts getting tough. You get broken hands in some rounds, have to carry on. Devin swinging on the back foot. Callum tries to get him up against the ropes. Though does get him up against the ropes. Nice head movement there from Dylan. He's landed a few. And this may just come down to who's got more stamina, who's got the fight in them to get through to that last round. Dylan looking very comfortable now, but Callum still trying to keep busy. Throwing big shots, switching from body to head. Final 10 seconds. Round number 7. Great work again. I mean, these two have not stopped since they got in that ring. And it's almost, you start to feel it's going to be a shame for whoever Disney go home with that belt. Because up until now, both of them deserve it. But they've got one more hurdle to overcome, and that's each other. But great work, I'm loving this. Let me know your thoughts online, keep the comments coming in. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. We've only got 26 people liking, there's 230 of you watching. You're watching it for free, mate. You're watching it for free. So get that like button hit. And if you do have a few quid that you want to spare, JTV Goals Youth Mentoring Project is in the description. Here we go, round number 8. We've said since this contest was booked, this would be a tough, I keep saying it, 50-50 contest. Darren really trying to keep the pressure on Darren. Darren, keep that guard up. You need to take that in consideration as well, how much is landing.
Man. I just watched the table, innit?
No. The other way, the other way. Cheers, sister. Sorry, we had a wee bit of a technical issue there. It should be Wiz. No. These two keep the momentum up. Carl definitely trying to keep busy this round. Dylan using that ring space, trying to give himself a wee bit of a breather at times. Dylan trying to find big shots there as he goes to the body. Been a few settings around number 8. So apologies, a wee bit of a technical issue that happened there. I think we've sorted it out. We are in a busy venue. We're using their Wi-Fi. It's not always great. Keep the comments coming in. Genie1976. It's Callum bringing it now. Go on, son. We get Cameron Tillman supporting Callum as well. Matty Clark. Let's get Callum up 2 rounds. Louise Rankin agrees with me. We'll come down to the stamina. Shout out to Mark Real Life Boxing.
4 or 10 seconds.
Somebody like swung back and hit into my table earlier just as internet was sort of crunching. Here we go.
Round number nine.
Dylan Abico in the pink and white shorts. Callum Tombo in the gold and white. This is for the Scottish Super Bantamweight Championship belt. I did say the boxers, since the first 10 rounder, they need to pace themselves to land at 10. Not either of them stopped. But Dylan did take a wee breather here and there. I wonder if this is part of the plan. Carl getting a wee bit cocky. Big body shot there landing. Seven does not lay up. Oh, this is brilliant. Both these boxers have put their heart and soul into this. This crowd nearly getting behind both boxers. This is mad, man. Not one of them was lit up through this battle. Absolute battle. Final 10 seconds of round number 9. That's it, Bill. We'll be back in just a sec. So guys, welcome back. You're watching GTV Live's coverage. This is the final round of the final contest. Nice show of respect there between both these boxers. Devin Arbico in the red corner, Callum Turnbull in the blue. Could come down to this round. Our supporters online, some have Devon up, some have Callum up. And both boxers will be wanting to seal the deal, have a big finish. But both have earned each other's respect, they've also earned the right to hold that title. Big there, landed. Dillon, we just shook it off and continued. And that's the thing, not one of them is back down. When there is these big shots landing, either the body or the head. The crowd's really getting behind these two. As I said, they've earned the crowd's respect, earned each other's respect. Big shots are landed from Devon. Can Callum keep that stamina as he has done throughout? he's still smiling. As I said, he loves to box. If he needs to take it to a scrap, as we've seen. Final few seconds around. Number 10. Wow. Absolute belter of a performance there for both these boxers. I don't know what else to say, man. If you're going to be watching that YouTube boxing push later, I can say this is after the watershed. It's my channel. Go fuck yourself. This is real boxing. This is Scottish boxing at its best. UK boxing. We're going to pass to Craig Stephen in the ring with the official announcement. Don't go anywhere. We'll have a Scottish super bantamweight champion for you in just a few moments. Guys, you're watching JTV Live's coverage of SM Promotions North vs West Showdown. The main event just finished. Darren Arbico and Callum Tombo. The belt was in the ring. Let's pass to Craig Stephen with an official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we declare the result, our referee, Mr. Pringle, has asked that you join him and congratulate both these boxers on an absolutely fantastic contest. You can watch all you want on television, nothing beats the real thing here in Scotland, ladies and gentlemen. We go to Mr. Pringle's score totals. It's close, it's 96-95. The winner, who is now the Scottish Super Bantamweight Champion from Newark. Somewhere down the line, we're going to see this again. Please, your appreciation, the man from Inverness, Callum Turnbull!
Yes!
So, ladies and gentlemen, two absolute warriors. Two boxers with total respect for each other. Two guys that have come through the amateurs, now in the pros. And I'm sure we will see this one again. Ladies and gentlemen, please, your appreciation for the new Scottish Super Bantamweight Champion, Dylan Arbuckle. So ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Stephen Hoare for SM Promotions, on behalf of our officials, on behalf of our boxers, thank you so much for coming out, for spending your hard-earned money, for supporting our boxers, supporting our local boxers, supporting our visiting boxers. I do a lot of boxing shows. It's a very, very good boxing crowd here in Inverness, and I don't say that lightly. Have a very safe journey home when you do go home. and we will look forward to seeing you the next time. From all of us here at the Dromossi, a very good night. Good night.
So guys, one absolute built up performance here from both boxers. Dylan is just grabbing. move up, Moonan. Dylan Orbico, Scottish Super Bantamweight Champion. Yeah. How does that sound?
Fantastic. Buzzing, man. Some fight.
I know, Wiz, man. Like, it came right down to it. It did look close. Both of you never took your foot off the gas. When it comes to that close and you're in that ring and you're hearing 96, 95, what's going through your mind?
Well, we thought we'd done enough to win it. We were saying that in the corner. Won a lot of the earlier rounds, but then you're away from home, aren't you? So you're always that wee thought in the back of your head, you're like, ah, fuck. But we fought comfortably that we won it there. It was a close fight. But I knew we got it.
Bro, it's just like some people were saying, forget all this YouTube shit, all these YouTube boxers. This is boxing, man. This is not just for Scottish boxing, but UK boxing, and like people could watch this for all the world. And both of you went in first 10 rounder as well.
Aye.
What was that like?
Well, that's the thing we said in the last interview. Radisson, well, I work our way up to six. I've done 3-4 rounders. Well, I've done 1-4 rounder, know what I mean? I've only been the distance in one. Well, we thought we'd get a 6 rounder and then start chasing titles next year, but this came up, you need to take opportunities like that.
The thing is, I know Callum, all the boxers that have been on the night, I've been up in Inverness before, I know that they put their heart and soul into it, but coming into like the Lions then as well, in Inverness with all his fans, you had a lot, all your fans are right in front of me, Ian Wilson as well, he could have sat in his seat, come on in. But what's it mean to you? Have that support? There's a lot of people watching online as well. I was glad we got the stream out and been able to, people can watch it for free. Can I get that anywhere else?
Well, there's only 17 of the boys here, but see what the sounds at. They sound outnumbered. We outnumbered them, aye.
So Ian, we're just saying, the last time I spoke to Dylan, we were saying he's got to work his way up, maybe get 6 rounders, 8 rounders. You just threw him right out of the deep end, but you believed in him, I think.
That's it, that's the thing. I massively believed in him to do it. My voice is totally gone, by the way. And I need to say credit to that boys. Well, I thought that was a lot tougher and a harder fight than I thought. And I came out about halfway, I went, we're dead level here. And at the end I went, know that people say it, I says there's a fag paper in this, there's nothing in this. And then fair enough, 96, 95, there was nothing in it, but I'm so proud of him, honestly. And he works hard and see people that are professional, put all the work in, all the rest of it is good. I could have done without nearly the heart attack at ringside, but I'm honestly, I'm delighted. And we've done, and do you know something? If they want to do that again down the line and we maybe go and try something else into it, great, but so proud of him. For stepping in from, he's better than six round fights, but he's never done six rounds, and he's gone through a 10 rounder, and that was a warrior attrition. That was a bloody war. Too much actually for my heart, but it was great. And
I was saying, it wasn't that long ago, I was sitting at ringside when you became Scottish Elite Champion. That wasn't that long ago. And to make that transition and then to go for belts, I mean, I love your persona outside the ring, and I love your focus and that inside the ring. He was trying to wind you up at times. I seen you were smiling on your way back to the corner. You've seen it all, done it all anyway. You know what to expect in the ring. Did that get under your skin at any point?
No. See the way I'm in the ring, I'm the same out the ring, I'm way back, so take a lot to wind me up, you know what I mean? So see all of that, fucking just gives you my head. It's a fine ball, okay. Let's go.
So in a few weeks' time, we've got the Arwa show.
Yeah, that's a few weeks' time, but I think tonight's, honestly, for me, just all about Dylan. That was a huge, it was a big step up, jumping. It was a big gamble. I went like, because you've got, well, let's go to 10 rounds, do it. And he's come through and he's won it. And honestly, but you can hear my voice. I cannot be happier, honest. And this is what it's all about. It's having real fights. Scottish boxing's real fights, some great fighters. And the reason he's done it, because he's professional. He's fit as anything, and he lives a life. If you don't live a life, you're not doing things like that. And that's what, and huge credit to that as well. Fantastic. They might do that again down the line for, who knows, it might be an eliminator or whatever, but it was honest, I'm so proud of him. Fantastic.
Let's see that belt before you go, man. Let's see. You know, nobody take it off. Here we go. Listen, Dylan, thanks so much. Who are we going to shout it to? Who's been supporting you?
Well, I'd like to shout out Michael Carlin. Michael's got to come up, but I think he's busy. Michael's my main sponsor. Michael's helped me out a lot. Heart of gold, great man. So a big shout out to him, big shout out to the boys that came up. I mean, it's a trek away.
I know, man. But tell me about it. I came up with all the equipment and that in the chain with you, man. What is it? What's it? Initial plans, are you looking forward to maybe, I remember Cash used to always go to like Bistro for like after a chips cheese donner or something, and then it was right back into training. What is the plan for you?
I'll no stop training, know what I mean, but I like a munch after this, know what I mean, so I'll pig out a bit, but I'll still be in the gym. I don't take days off and that, but we'll take a wee hang, get a wee break over Christmas now, and I'll be back out in February, you were saying earlier on, so I've got a wee break and then back to it.
Man, listen, Devin Arbuckle, Scottish super bantamweight champion. I'll let you go celebrate, man. Somebody's big in shorts, I don't want any of that. Fuck, I'll let you go celebrate with him, my man. Guys, that was Devin Arbuckle, the new Scottish super bantamweight champion. You've been watching JTV Live's coverage of the SM Promotions North vs West Showdown. I'm not going to be able to get a chance to chat to Carlin, but I will catch up with him. As I said, I've known him for years. Great boxer. Both of them put their heart and soul in it. Thanks so much for the support as well that's been coming in online. You can watch all this back. We will get HD versions out as well. But until next time, have a great night. And I'll see you all very, very soon.